Is humanity's future inside virtual reality? Tech companies are making big bets that the answer is yes. The company formerly known as Facebook, rebranded to Meta, is under the belief that the metaverse, a world created through mixed virtual and augmented reality, is the next chapter for the internet, with 1 billion people spending time in the metaverse within a decade. Meta spent $36 billion through Q3 2022 investing in VR, taking enormous losses on its vision of the future. And Meta isn't the only tech giant investing big. Apple has been rumored for years to be developing a VR headset. Sony, HTC, Valve, and others already make them. Are these companies betting right? And if they are, what does it mean for humanity's future to design our own reality? In a way, humanity could be said to have been building towards virtual reality for millennia. Storytelling, theater, and art can all be seen as early low-tech efforts in our attempts to build our own realities and absorb others in them. Photography and filmmaking provided new ways to do just that. Stereoscopes, first invented in 1838, look amazingly similar to today's VR devices, and for the first time, brought people into virtual 3D worlds, transporting them to places on Earth they might otherwise never visit. The ViewMaster, a popular childhood toy for most of the 20th century, represents likely the most commercially successful stereoscope. Humanity has long imagined more developed virtual realities. Science fiction author Lawrence Manning's 1933 series of short stories, The Man Who Awoke, described a faraway future in which people replace their senses with machine-created electrical impulses, choosing to live in virtual worlds. Some visions of the future imagine a VR utopia, such as Star Trek's holodeck, in which VR provides recreation in a harmonious star-faring society. But other visions are distinctly dystopian, such as The Matrix, recognizing the danger the technology might bring. Others fit somewhere in the middle, such as Neal Stephenson's 1992 novel Snow Crash, where the term metaverse originally comes from. The development of modern VR took decades. At first far too bulky to be head-mounted, 1962's Sensorama had people sit in a booth with a stereoscopic color display, fans, odor emitters, stereo sound system, and a moving chair. This developed into the 4D films popular at amusement parks. The first headset to display primitive computer-generated 3D images was the Sword of Damocles, invented in 1968 by Harvard University's Ivan Sutherland. Its augmented reality paved the way for the first virtual reality headset in 1979, the Large Expanse Extra Perspective, or LEAP, optical system used by NASA. Paired with VPL Research's motion sensing data glove, they allowed people to interact in an immersive virtual environment for the first time. In the early 90s, head-mounted VR began to hit arcades with the Virtuality and Sega's VR1 system. In 1995, consumer VR first hit homes with the Forte VFX1 and Nintendo's ill-fated Virtual Boy, discontinued after only a year on the market and widely criticized for causing dizziness, nausea, and headaches. Meanwhile, in the decades this hardware was developing, so was software. The technology for computer graphics that allowed for video games increasingly provided more and more realistic virtual worlds. Early metaverses, such as Second Life, launched in 2003, allowed players to explore a user-generated world with a functioning economy, with real-world brands opening stores. The current era of VR is largely considered to have begun in 2012, when then-19-year-old Palmer Luckey founded Oculus VR and dramatically advanced consumer-grade VR technology. Less than 2 years later, the company was purchased by Facebook for $3 billion, and numerous other hardware developers followed in their footsteps. While the primary use of VR remains recreational, including video games, film experiences, and adult entertainment, its current-day use goes far beyond recreation and are rapidly expanding. Exercise is a popular use of VR, with Meta having purchased the popular VR exercise app, Supernatural. In general, physical fitness can be expected to improve with adoption of VR, as people move in a virtual space rather than sit behind a static screen. Meta has also positioned VR as the future of business, with remote meetings to take place in virtual workrooms, with a dramatically improved sense of presence over today's more common video chat applications. One study found that VR meetings led to higher levels of consensus, satisfaction, and team cohesion. Prototyping vehicle design is already nearly ubiquitously done using VR, and VR has substantial medical applications. It's a proven tool with a strong success rate for providing safe access to triggering stimuli in exposure therapy for people with PTSD. It's shown promise in therapy for eating disorders, gender dysphoria, and depression, including by improving mood in disabled and elderly people, by making it easier for them to virtually get out of their homes and explore the world. It has utility in physical therapy to help rehabilitate those with strokes and Parkinson's disease, and it can allow surgeons to train for surgery and even operate remotely. Its ability to safely simulate experiences also makes it useful in training for the military, pilots, emergency response workers, divers, astronauts, and more. In education, it provides a way to bring students from anywhere in the world together and allows children to experience history and science right before their eyes. The Chinese government has already announced plans to introduce VR into their education system. The near future of VR is exciting enough, but it's the far future that has truly both enticed and frightened science fiction readers and thinkers. Will we truly one day live in a VR metaverse that feels as real as the material world? Well, we have a couple technological challenges we'd have to pass first, but rapid progress is being made. Each year brings new resolution, field of view, and other advancements in lens and screen technology. Experiments are also occurring in projecting images directly onto the eye's retina. The most cutting-edge consumer devices now not only track full body motion, but eye and face micro-movements, bringing all non-verbal communication into the virtual world. Treadmills are being developed to allow unlimited movement in any direction through virtual worlds. Google has patented VR shoes with wheels that would do the same. Early bodysuits and gloves provide force feedback and sensation to interact with virtual elements. 360-degree 3D cameras get smaller and smaller, and soon will likely make it easier to capture and relive memories with immersion far beyond the 2D camera currently in your pocket. At the most niche, there are experiments in virtual smell and even taste. Perhaps with enough time, such external technology can so develop to make the virtual world indistinguishable from the material one. Or perhaps the future of VR might look more like that originally envisioned in The Man Who Awoke or in The Matrix with direct brain connections. Such technology might not be as far away as you'd think. Elon Musk's company Neuralink announced in November of 2022 that one of the first applications of their brain implant will be to restore vision in the blind by bridging the connection between cameras and the visual cortex. But once a connection is established to send data to the visual cortex, it's just as easy to imagine sending an artificial image. If we can send data to the visual cortex, sending data to our other senses shouldn't be far off. As it has throughout the advancement of virtual reality, we can continue to expect that as hardware develops, so will the software it delivers. Advances in artificial intelligence, image generation such as the Stable Diffusion and DALL-E AIs, now allow incredibly detailed images to be created in seconds from a written description. Such technology could evolve into the full creation of virtual worlds and characters from one's command, turning humans into gods. You could like and subscribe, not just to YouTube videos and channels like ours, but to advanced and fully immersive virtual experiences beyond your current imagination. Such a society would be vastly different from the one we have today. Super intelligent AI mixed with virtual reality promises a world in which the concerns of material reality are a thing of the past, and all of our desires are at our fingertips. This future frightens many people. What does it mean to be a human when you're so disconnected from the demands of material reality and the pursuits that have historically given us meaning? How might childhood mental development differ in such a future where nothing is real and thus the rules of traditional morality no longer apply? Or, conversely, might VR increase empathy by allowing us to fully step into each other's shoes and truly experience things from their perspective? But what is human connection even like in a world where you could wish for an AI friend, lover, and even family into your life that feels just as real as biological people? You may think this is a future you don't want, but will you be able to avoid it when it comes, if indeed it arrives within your lifetime? Many of us long avoided joining social media, or getting a smartphone, or adopting other technological advancements that made life easier but came with serious trade-offs, yet caved eventually after the technologies became core parts of our society. Will this one be any different as we slowly advance towards it? Will humanity achieve this future, or will technological limitations prevent its arrival? Are you looking forward to being the god of your personal VR universe? Or do you fear the abandonment of what it has always meant to be a human? Join the conversation and predict the future with us down in the comments. Beyond Now is a new channel dedicated to helping people connect with humanity and the universe's past and to inspire them to dream about the future. We have big plans to create much more content doing just that. In addition to liking, commenting, and subscribing, we hope you'll also consider supporting Beyond Now to enable us to continue making videos and grow our channel by becoming a patron. Our Patreon offers a community to think big with other supporters and to get early access to Beyond Now videos and bonus content. No matter how you choose to support us, we truly appreciate it. We rely on viewer support, and your help enables us to achieve our goal of spreading human connection and inspiration. Thank you so much for watching and supporting Beyond Now.